I'll never forget that morning. I had already missed the school bus, but I stood there anyway, watching and envying the birds. That pond was pure bliss growing up. I can't remember if I had a fishing pole or not, but there definitely wasn't any fish. I didn't need to catch anything anyway. I once spent an entire Saturday afternoon trying to climb on top of one of those hay bales just so I could take a nap in the sun. When I finally did it, I was too happy to fall asleep. Funny that in a decrepit grave of a house, I found something beautiful a stranger had left a long time ago. I would stare at it for ages after a bad day. I've tried over and over to draw it how I remember, but it's not the same. One day I'll find that stranger, and I'll say thank you. The neighbor's dog was my best friend. I'd save up all my money just to buy him food and to talk to him for a while. For some reason, though, he would never go past the fence. I would beg and plead, but eventually he would just run back home. Why was he scared? I almost never went into that old cemetery, but that morning I did. I guess I wanted to feel something, even if it was only fear. I was terrified because of a vivid memory. I remember I'd lost something important, and I realized it was near that graveyard. I gathered up all my courage, imagining how Princess Leia would act. Right as I stepped into the gates, I heard a ghost screaming at me. I ran as fast as I could, and I never looked back. I had walked around the woods a million times by myself, but it felt different that morning. I thought about how ancient those giant trees were, and how they were probably the same size when I was born. It seemed so long ago when I was a baby. That morning was the first time in my life I realized that I was growing up. father locked the shed because I stole something from him. All I remember thinking is, if that thing was gone, my old dad would come back and things would be better. I was wrong. I once made my own fort in the woods and called it my mansion. I imagined it being this giant house with furniture and a TV. And I even had separate rooms for toys and for tinkering with computers. It was a place where everything was better. It was home. I wish I could forget that smell, the smell of alcohol mixed with mold. I hated that trailer, even when my father was away at work. After walking around, started to think. I started to feel brave. My father had hidden a key in his room, so I went to go get it. I had an obsession with space. I thought I'd be the first astronomer to discover a planet beyond Pluto. I also thought birds could fly anywhere, even to outer space. To be a bird and to fly to other planets, I couldn't imagine a more perfect life. At that moment, all the invisible walls in my life disappeared. What I would give to ride that bike one more time.